Okay, in this video, we're going to talk about the first derivative test, although we're not quite going to get to the first derivative test. First thing we're going to do is define a couple terms. So if you have a function, f of x, so consider the one that I drew over here, this is f of x, then a local maximum, a function has a local maximum at c, so c would be like your x value, if f at c is bigger than all f at x close to c. So that just means the y value of c is higher than all the y values around it. The reason we call this a local maximum and not a maximum is, as you can see with this function, there's actually y values bigger, but they're not close to a. So it's sort of a maximum, but just in that area. And then a function is said to have a local minimum at c, so a minimum, if kind of the opposite is true, so here's a different c value. If f at c is less than f at x, so the y values at c are smaller than all the y values close. But again, you might have smaller y values somewhere else in the function. So that's our definition for local max and local mins. So one thing to notice, or what we're going to want to do, is figure out where these occur. So we're going to connect this to the slopes of the tangent. A function might have this local maximum or minimum. So notice this maximum occurs, the slope of the tangent is, or the tangent is horizontal, so the slope of the tangent is 0. So they can occur when you have a horizontal tangent, which we know that means the derivative is 0, or when the tangent is undefined. So remember, like your absolute value function, we said at the corner there is no tangent, so this would mean f prime at c does not exist. So these are kind of your potential points where you might get local maximum and minimums. And in fact, we give these points a special name. So these values of c, where f prime at c was equal to 0 or f prime at c was undefined, these are called critical numbers. Okay. And if a function has a local maximum or a local minimum at c, then c must be a critical number. So f prime at c equals 0, f prime at c is undefined. So these kind of two pictures I gave you, that's the only way you can get maximum or minimums. The derivative has to be 0, or the derivative has to be undefined. One thing to note about this, though, and this is an important point, is you could have critical numbers that are not maximums or minimums. So consider this function f at x equals x cubed. So we know what that looks like. And clearly from the graph, there are no maximums or minimums. But if you were to take the derivative, set it equal to 0, you would get x equals 0. So x equals 0 is a critical number. But there is no max or min, or maximum or minimum. Okay, so all critical numbers don't necessarily correspond to maximum or minimums, but if you do have a maximum or minimum, it has to be a critical.